Pasuan, welcome back to another monologue about Sakura the Reset. And man, this show, I don't know why, it got worse after the first two episodes, but still, I can't really drop it, because I'm still somewhat curious to where this show is actually going, and what the fuck is happening. But let's talk about this scene at the beginning of the episode when Kei was sitting in the train and a dude sat next to him and gave him a phone and said, well, answer the call. And this was how he got into the city of Sakurada. Very fishy, very strange, and why the fuck is such a young kid riding the train alone? But okay, that's another topic. So he talked with the witch and he met this witch later on. And her ability is to see the future of people or the city. And man, where do I even begin? A girl shows up with the ability to seal other abilities. And she was threatening him at the end of the episode with sealing Haruki's reset ability. And basically, she says that she is a villain, so I wonder if she will be one of those, well, we have a villain and now the MC has to overcome this, which would be so boring. And she said something that made me curious and question this entire show with, why didn't we get to this point yet? Or why did we start after this? Because she said that he was badass. When the fuck was he badass? I mean, yes, a couple of screw loose, but badass? I mean, badass? He? The main character? When the fuck did that happen? And I would like to see it, what kind of person he was when he was badass. Because I can't really believe it. But I'm curious and I would like to see it, kinda. But yeah, overall this episode was, well, I don't really get the purpose of this episode. Aside the, oh, the bureau was founded around the time when the abilities appeared. And that guy that lost his abilities and was asking for the MacGuffin was, well, he was one of the founders. And also the girl at the end, she wants to take the MacGuffin away from Kei. So, yeah. Is this MacGuffin still thing still well, metaphor or something like this, or is this actual stone really powerful? Who knows? We don't know yet. But man, oh, and when Haruki and Kei were talking about how he would feel if she would die and someone would show up who looks like Haruki, he was like, well, sad, very sad. And the total dialogue was like, oh, it's a nice weather. Yeah, it is, but it will rain tomorrow. Oh, yeah, this is sad. The level of emotions in it were like, how can I say it without sounding like an asshole? Oh yeah, they were non-fucking existent. I mean, I know we have those two with issues, but come on. Not showing emotions at all? I mean, let's leave Haruki aside who cries for others but not for herself, but he as well. So, such an emotionless brick, man, this show is going down a crazy road, and I wonder if they will be able to fix it. So yeah, I'm still going to watch it and I'm still going to talk about it, but yeah, something is strange. It really is strange. But strange things aside, thanks for watching and I will see you guys later. Bye bye.